The suggestion to revive the idea of a Galway Lorient cruise was made by Endo Cunningh at a meeting held aboard Evolution in July 2018. Others at the meeting included Mayor of Galway Neil McNeilis, John Killeen, Brian Sheridan the Harbour Master, Declan Dooley and myself, Cormac McDonagh. The objective of the whole initiative was to rebuild the cultural links between both cities, and in particular to rekindle some of the sailing fraternity relationships. I tried to knock some sense into Enda and his expectations of a huge flotilla, telling him to expect up to 3 boats. While Jean Gab and I toyed with the idea, Michael O'Donnell of Big Mama stepped forward and declared that we now had a flotilla. Put a list together of everyone I knew that had a tub on the bay, and I created the original controversial, highly probable, medium probable, low probable list of possible attendees. We agreed the dates and established an 1,100 nautical mile round trip course. To our amazement, people started to sign up. Maybe Enda wasn't that crazy after all. We started to get really positive engagement from the Scillies, Kinsale, Dugras and Lorient. The most hilarious emails came from our new best buddy in Lorient, Pádraig Larkin from the Cleda, owner of the Galway Inn. Early on, we got a great response from the Commodore of Mayo Sailing Club, Duncan Sclair, and a good number of boats from the Westport Club. They coolly added another 200 nautical miles to the trip. The Mayor of Galway at the time, Councillor Neil McNeilis, was a huge supporter. He committed funds and arranged for a reception in City Hall in April that was really successful. We had nearly 70 sailors at this early launch event. If you give some lads a podium, they love to speechify. At huge expense, we commissioned these daringly bold yellow battle flags, and the first one was hoisted on Newfoundland in the docks. Fair play to Winky Nixon, editor of the Afloat magazine. Not only did he give us great coverage of the planning and the trip itself, but he also called up to give us great encouragement. The inimitable Johnny Shorten came aboard, and then we knew we were off. You can see Johnny's skipper here, Tony Collins, skulking in the dark background trying to dissociate himself from any trouble. Johnny organized an excellent series of winter talks that were very well attended. The first talk we had covered international boat registration, where we tried to put the shits up everybody concerning the workload that was ahead of them. Subject matter expert and professional in this field, old friend Bronwyn O'Donnell came down and gave us a free talk. No stranger to representing Ireland herself. Next, we had another old friend and expert, John Roberts, well known to GBSE and other Western clubs alike, give us an excellent talk on navigation and passage planning. Oh, I just remembered I have to return some pilotage books and almanacs. Sorry about that, John. All sorts of books about long cruising and fancy almanacs showed up in Santy's stocking that Christmas. Johnny Shorten himself gave us an excellent talk on boat preparation and safety, which went down really well with the audience. So we all got ourselves busy forging CE plates so that we could get boats registered, adding new fancy artwork so that our boats were recognized, kitting ourselves out with medical equipment, getting stuck into acquiring all the safety gear, finding the right courtesy flags to fly, going online to find the right charts, getting Galway crystal gifts engraved. And then, of course, there were the mandatory two songs to learn off. But most importantly, lining ourselves up with some seriously good crew. It was a short winter.
Words fall through me and always fool me, and I can't react. And games that never amount to more than they're meant will play themselves out.
Down at the docks with more and more yellow flags hoisted amongst the fleet. Great excitement in Thermoking with 7 employees sailing on 5 different boats in the flotilla. People were getting edgy as the big day got closer and closer. We were starting to get good coverage in the local and national press. More great coverage from Winky Nixon in a float. Finally, we got word that Jangab and the 3 other Lurion boats had set sail. First to Galway was Michel Guillermic and his Sunfast 36 Jackedy. About a week later, Jangab Sanson and his crew rode into town on Trilogy, their Admiralier 46.
And you took the wind right out of my sail.
And soon there were 3, as Francois Bouillet tied up his beautiful Halsberg Rassy 42 Avan Glass at the Docks Marina. Of course, it wasn't long before Jangab was a celebrity around town. And then the Bannermen were in on the act, whisking Jangab down to Milltown Malbay for a bit of set dancing.
Still dreaming
It was soon time for the going away party, sponsored by Dara O'Connor and the Harbour Hotel.
Not leaving.
Outstanding efforts were made to decorate the Harbour Hotel by Pierce Purcell and his merry crew. Later on, the crowd of 150 souls were subjected to some serious speechifying. There was a sad note to the timing of our event because 4 weeks earlier, three SNSM volunteers had lost their lives off Les Sables de Lune. All of the crews contributed to a collection that we made to hand over to the SNSM in De Grau later that month. New mayor, Claddaman Mike Hubbard, was full of enthusiasm. The time had finally arrived for the departure. Ooh, a tight squeeze with all the cameras watching. We said our goodbyes to family because we wouldn't be seeing them for a couple of weeks. Meanwhile, other boats were leaving Westport and Kilrush.
I'm not listening.
Here's Fintan and the lads schmoozing out of Kilrush Marina.
It's all dust.
Captain Ganyu, our French consul, did a superb job at generating press interest.
Still to come on 6-1 this evening, renewing links with his twin cities.
We were the stars of 6-1 news that evening.
In France, that sail from Galway destined from Lorient in France. The special voyage marks the twin status of the two cities. A French lifeboat crew who died in a sea rescue last month is being remembered on the journey.
Preparing to set sail for France, these Irish and French crews want to honour the bravery of the three men who lost their lives at sea. They had been coming to the aid of a fishing vessel off the coast of Brittany during Storm Miguel last June. The voyage also marks the strong maritime and cultural links between the twin cities of Galway and Lorient.
They wanted part of his voyage to actually send their condolences and their sympathy by sending a signed flag and a letter of condolence that will be travelling on one of the boats today and going to Île de Groix near Lorient and will be given to the Lorient Sea Rescue on the island.
The fleet includes classic traditional West of Ireland crafts, including the Galway hooker. Each will carry sods of turf on board as a symbolic gesture to the Celtic ties between Brittany and the west of Ireland.
The turf on the Galway hookers is one of the best symbols we can have to say that people have been living for generations making this type of transport and traditional transport.
We're strong Celtic traditionalists and we're more than happy. It was very easy to re-engage each other and the relationships rebuilt immediately.
Next year marks the revival of a tradition of sailing trips between Galway and Lorient. They will be celebrating 45 years as twin cities next year and there will be a lot of projects on board. Meanwhile, the first stopover for this fleet is Kinsale on Sunday for Bastille Day. Theresa Mannion, RTÉ News, Galway.
Fáiltear a bhur náis, anois tá tuch a bád tréis chun na galaibhe a ghagantar maidin. Agus iad ag
déanamh... An tagart faoin méid sim a bhuamad ó T.G. Cathair, cumá.
...an dlú cheangal idir an dá áit a abhuascailt a ríist.
Mar chumara eit chrú tí siúr a bahú tí bhád tárála as an bhrank le linn stéir Miguel ar an seachtú mithiv. Tá tréch a bád a dá chun na galaibhe maidin a tuirt fúi aistir chúchiad chúgad trí múrvíle go Lorient na Franca. Aistir a hócas os cén seachtana. Mar chóra ómáis gan na fit tá bratach síní de chud na Institute Náisiúnta Rígan na Máid Tárála nó an RNLI le litir cóbhrón le tuirt an nún. Bei mál na múna ar bhórd chulaháid freisin, mar chóra ar an gangal celtach idir an Bhriatán agus iarthar na héireann.
Bei na báda lúga báilú le chéile ar ilan De Grau taobh móga Lorient agus bei mú de lúg Cáhamh na bratacha sús agus golaseach le chéile. Dinnú an céad thuras seo 1976.
In 1962, gint an Cangal idir Calafort na Gaillimhe agus Lorion ar dús. Agus siar sna blianta, bheadh Cangal mór cultúr agus Celtach idir an dá chathair.
Renew or enhance the relationships.
Beidh sé ceartha cúig bliain an chéimhlín eile ó don nua an Clonas, agus tar a féachan sanis an Cangal a abhioch an arís, mar a deir John Gabb as Lorion. Bhí neart dína láthair chun slánagal ag na báid, agus neart cúnacab ó húcairí na Gaillimhe, an mac dúch agus crín chlada in na másc, agus Jean, drásásta an mún a hurt leis go Lorion.
Tá, tú te íntach agus beárad go bhaicin Jack agus Dara Mahonic as a rank go bíad na báid seol stáocht í gúnaí.
Tá ásarm ag feicúis le lán na díní an seo San Gáilíoth ag feicúis le na bádaí ag fágan go dí leis na Lorion, so tá sé íntach ar fad.
Tá man seo le tácaíocht a thuirt agus lán agus tá sílan go mbeidh turas maith acu agus íntach an ceangala go bhfuil sé fáil níos láidre ríist idir Gáilí agus Lorion, má tá ceangal an sinna blianta fada.
Mar chud den aistir, seas na báid in áitichaí ar mealach, cintáile ina measc ar an dúnach, lá na Bastíle.
Bad an lá bhíoch tradition láidirán ó mú na hárinnt go háirinn agus go chimara, a chuine tá síine a chud leis an turas sin agus iad na bealach go Lorion na Fraince. Éad an amhil ón, nucht tidí cahead i meile.
Are you sleeping?
Agus hosaí an turas go rialta, seo dé links go thairis na hoileán áirin.
Still drifting off along. I'm not leaving, but this feeling, see it better best be told. And how in the world did you come to be such a lazy love? Oh, it's so simple and fitting, the path that you are on. We're not talking.
Niamh had helpfully packed 2 kilos of bread soda in some clear plastic bags. The antidote to diarrhea, stuffed noses and various other ailments is also a marvelous cleaning agent. Is also a marvelous cleaning agent, or so I'm told.
And how am I supposed to live without you? A wrong word said in anger when you were gone. I'm not listening for signals. It's all dust now on the shelf. You still working?
Here we are, passing the bull.
Still buried in yourself. And how in the world.
There's the cow.
We come.
There's the calf.
To have such
a roamer, not far behind.
How am I supposed to live without you? A wrong word said in anger when you were gone. And how am I supposed to live without anyone? Oh, oh.
Morale was high aboard Ocean Tango on the first night out. A lovely evening. Three-hour watches were the order of the day.
Such a lady.
Well, if it isn't Princess Cahal himself, having tea in bed. Meanwhile, it's Dave O'Connor, Nigel Moss, Paddy the Sniper, Crazy Ian, and the gang. Pavel and the lads aboard Lean Machine won't be outdone. After a wonderful day and a half sailing down the west coast, we finally pull into Glendore for some R&R. You can spot a few yellow flags in the background because Jackadee, Big Mama, Trilogy, and Freebird are already up sculling pints in the village. What a fantastic view from Casey's Bar. E3. Here we are with Jackadee in our wake, heading for Kinsale. Others took the scenic route. Here's Split Point languishing in Cornwall. Brother and sister Maeve and Dermot McDonagh enjoying the scenery in Fooey, Cornwall. Beautiful sailing conditions as we approached Kinsale. Kinsale Yacht Club had caterers in for us and we had a smashing night. Donald Small greeted us on behalf of Kinsale Yacht Club. There was plenty of speechifying and Galway Crystal presentations to be handed over. Donald told us not to underestimate our achievement. They'd tried in Kinsale a number of times to organise flotillas, but they'd never actually managed to pull it off. So they signed up for it all right, but then they ended up heading their own separate ways. Fair play to Jocelyn Legal, the Munster French Consul, who came to greet us on Bastille Day. Cracks started to appear as the first signs of trouble were brewing. Day 4 was beautiful and belied some of the tough weather that was ahead of us. French boats sensibly adhered to the weather forecast, but the 7 or 8 Irish lads had itchy feet. We headed south for Sillies in ideal conditions. Rumour had it that some sailors were spotted on deck with some white powdery looking substance in clear plastic bags. GLE Samuel Beckett pulled alongside us as we approached the Kinsale gas fields and interrogated us for about 10 minutes before realising we were harmless. Could we find the call sign when we needed it? Could we feck? And there it was, riding behind the Eagle. Obviously, we had memorized all obstacles en route from our months of preparation. But that didn't stop us getting another bollocking. This time, from the crew of the gas platforms 50 miles south of Kinsale. Their opening salvo was to insult Ken's tiller work with a loose remark about his wavering course. And then he followed up with a cheap jibe about having the Navy lads onto us. And then the hammer blow. Some unwritten rule about not being able to go between the two platforms.
I see your course going away a little bit there. I know you've had the head leads on you there, but you can't pass between the rigs, you know that, don't you?
All right.
We know we can't pass between them. Say we do.
Yeah. Okay, we're tack now.
Yeah, roger that. Thank you.
Yeah, no hassle at all. Cheers. Safe voyage.
shut the door to the room. Let the birds gather. Play no more. Meanwhile, there were rumours of a mutiny aboard Imperator. The crew below deck were being led in some sort of primitive chant. Apparently, there was one ringleader who seemed to have the crew in a trance. Elsewhere, the rest of the fleet were consumed by the daily routine. Using an old Polish technique, Paweł Bozonski had pre-cooked a good number of meals and sealed them in glass jars, providing us with excellent nutrition throughout. Although I drew the line at toast with gherkins, Nutella and cheese. Woohoo! The sillies have been spotted! Morale is up and all thoughts of worn fan belts are long forgotten.
Playing our Galway 2020.
The thrill is gone, baby. The thrill is gone away. You know you done me
wrong. Dinghy ready to go.
And you'll be sorry.
We were soon picking up a mooring in St. Mary's. As the yellow flags piled in day by day, the smart arse who collects the mooring fees asked Jerry Moran if there was anybody still left in Galway. Winky was quick to the typewriter. Lynx had just got there before us, and we knew that because you could hear the hoors a mile off. Harbour Master Dale Clark was a gentleman. He also told us that he was surprised that we showed up in such big numbers. He said flotillas often tell them they're coming, but they never actually appear. He was delighted to accept the engraved Galway Crystal and the GBSE Club Burgee. Pilot boat flew the Burgee proudly for the few days while we were there. The locals were fantastic at sourcing us some spare fan belt. While the shelter on the islands can be poor, it was ideal for our visit. You can see a number of yellow fleet flags flying here in the distance. A good night beckoned. We started with a few thirsty pints in the Mermaid. The furniture and walls were used to stop tired sailors from falling over. Next morning, we wandered around the village. From coffee shop to coffee shop, where we met other crews and bored the arse off each other, sharing exhilarating sailing stories. I spotted this shop sign and thought that skipper of Calico Jack, Connor O'Byrne, might be amused. This archipelago of low altitude sandy islands was beautiful and had some very unique flora and fauna. Here's you, Fanzel, heading for France. Poco soon after.
And now that it's all over, on you go, thanks. All I can do is wish you well.
Not a great forecast with up to 25 knots promised on the nose. We decided to drop our main completely and hoist the smaller of our two headsets.
even at that, with no crew out on the rail, it was a struggle holding the tiller at times. Not much fun as we weaved across the shipping lanes in the darkness in poor weather. Sleeping with both eyes open was the order of the day. More reports of turmoil aboard Imperator had been coming over the wires. Apparently, nobody had been getting any sleep for days, as Angus couldn't be stopped. His accomplices appeared to be in a trance. On and on it went, incessantly. Tune after unrelenting tune. Some permanent damage seems to have been inflicted. Elsewhere, the winds had finally eased, and a level of serenity was restored all round. On Lean Machine, Eugene's daughter's MP3 player and boombox were providing great entertainment for the crew.
Full moon.
Here's another one coming. At 20 knots. Man, this one's going to go straight through us. Phew! That one, like just the others, passed a couple of hundred meters either in front or behind. As we were crossing the shipping lanes, we entered international waters and we got a sniff of France. Time to pull out the French pilotage books. Of course, the logbooks also had to be updated. Finally, some of the boats hit the French coast. Here you can see Romer, moored up at Ushant Island off the northwest coast of France. In the background, you'll spot Inishbarracon and Imperator. Who's went ashore and did a bit of foraging? Yep, it was France, all right.
Yellow flags there already. John Mann hasn't hoisted them yet. Shut the door.
Cormac McDonagh in Galasha was keen shachtanachan, magra chud wadis fe ilug da tarasa yna as irhor na heiran galariant na Francia, dag baid as rasabil as dud na gaelive as cahir na mart agus as kilrush ed an dara laidze galisha agus chushad galariant na Francia aru reid agus ta Cormac lumunish in a vôn in adas lariant. Cechol tu Cormac?
Hello, Fanula.
Cechol wil tu?
Gmaagamad.
Cynsor taish dir vinun agai?
We should raise on tomorrow. Sputty Garava, three to three, we should get death curtain.
It's been Amshir Magalior Martian at Malachanum.
Amshir Gahinto, really, Tom, I can't find Guyuan. We've been Amshir Gahinto, really, more or less a Malachar fad. So,
you're ain't a teen Martianara?
Well, you didn't know about China, right? Actually, but Amad Hanagas, Rasalil, the Nirjan Chinasafu or Kashi Chimple.
So, oh, the Kretur.
Yeah, Anthony Privet, August and Crew, Kashi Chimple, Jim Shidresh, go Kilrush or Mada.
Oh, Spochtash.
August. Oh, the one, Ella, Niro, Mohan Crew, who said Dan Sheep, he's the Glendore. Actually, we be fair coig thought in number one Rinland on Paris, so three bought Lorion out of the or Ever in the hair. So yeah, long thought to Lingham.
Morale is high on Lean Machine on a nice overnight trip heading south past the northwest French coast.
Can't see a fucking thing.
Dan, what's the code?
There's no code on it, it's not on.
That's the Res de Saint on your left over there. And we're heading for Kimper. You just have to believe me.
Yes. This is Imperator confirming our position. Over. This is going to be one of your ears, Tony, has come out the other ear.
Clearly. Psychological stability was proving a challenge for all of the crews.
You're ready, starters.
Lynx were coping in their own way.
Sleeping, still dreaming, still drifting off alone, not leaving this feeling, see it better this be told. And how in the world did you come?
Some fancy graphics from Inish Barakon's AIS as they approached the shipping lanes. Aha, but John Roberts would be proud of Tony Collins and Angus and a bit of old-fashioned sextant and chart work.
I can't. Tough as nails.
We're not talking. There's no secret. It's just a note.
It's all around as we came in striking distance of Ile de Groix. After 3 days at sea, we finally pulled into Ile de Groix. We were dreaming of hot showers, static toilet bowls, and hot restaurant food served on plates.
The envelope! Cormac, get down there and kiss the ground.
It's all dust now.
Welcome.
And more excitement as Sister Maeve, Skipper Seamus Gilroy, and Fiona Christie safely pulled into De Groix.
Such an absent love, oh. And how am I supposed to live without you? A wrong word said in anger when you were gone. And how am I supposed to live without you?
This is De Groix, and you can see three of the yellow flags over there. There are a few more coming in. In fact, there's one just coming in over the pier wall there, I think. Yeah. And there's about 12 or 13 of them over there. So, yeah, we'll have a good crowd here, it seems.
Fair play to the locals. They absolutely had the red carpet out for us. Jangab and Catherine were fantastic. They stuffed us into their estate car and drove us up to their holiday cottage, where we were treated to a champagne reception.
So we just after having a champagne lunch. Mr. Shorten, there's no total chancer. There's the princess, Princess Cahill. Here you are, lads. I'm going there. Say hello, men. Hello to the fans.
Niamh was researching a few Breton words for the speeches later. Good job I tested out my accent, because no one had a clue what I was saying. I'm just going. There was great pride in the fleet that we had delivered such numbers and such an impressive spectacle. I'm just going. We had about 10 of our number on the moorings.
There's the ferry coming.
And a further 12 down on the marina. You gather around me.
I know my pain. Is rough and steep,
but golden fields stretch out before me, where weary eyes. In all, we had 27 boats participate in the flotilla. 24 of them made it to De Grasse and sailed to Lorient together. Roughly 130 sailors were involved. I'm
going there. How are you, lads? No good. More too long. Christine, how are you?
Good, well, you too.
Great. Yeah. Looking forward to the music later.
Oh, exactly. Did you have a good time at John Gabb's place?
We did.
Yeah. I'm just going. Nice place, eh?
Isn't it? Yeah. See you in a bit. Over home. I'm going there to see my mother. She said she'd meet me when I come.
There was great interest in our activities locally, and you can see here that we featured as the L'Image du Jour in the West France Daily. I'm just going. The Ile de Groix Marina was an interesting design. It was an inner harbour which was maintained at the 8 metre high tide, and then as the tide dropped, the gate closed. The locals were very proud of their single oar skulls, the Gaudi.
I'm going there to see my father. He said he'd meet me. It's not going that well. When I come. Oh, sorry, Carl. It's going extremely well. It's going extremely well. I'm going there. Over Jordan. I'm just a going
to my new home. Tarnation, I am in your debt.
Choctaw Nation, I just want to thank you.
Fair play to Anya too, aboard Rokadar, for getting the spirit of Galway safely to De Grasse. Crack was on down at the Café de la Jette. Some lads were drinking two at a time to make up for lost drinking days at sea. Breton spirit was something to behold. Breton first, Celtic second, French third. Of course, the crew of Chillon had clean laundry wherever they went. The young lads, led by 74-year-old Justin Shorten, were on the tear. Proud dad recording the wonderful singing voice of Aaron McInerney. The father figures making sure that things didn't get out of hand. One side event was a mini reunion of about a dozen engineering graduates from UCG in the 80s.
Turn into love song. Cela ne te fait rien que ma sœur m'ait laissé faire seule le service. Dis-lui donc je t'aimais.
Welcome Tim into her house. She had a sister called Mary who sat down at the Lord's feet and listened to him speaking.
Next up was a slap-up meal in the Salle de Fête. A couple of glasses of wine and they were all singing. Thumbs up all round. Even the Mayo crowd were well behaved. Lot of smugness about. But mostly it was a warm, memorable engagement with the locals. Cathal Byrne from Galway RNLI handed over our collection to the local SNSM crew. The collection reached €1,100.
Thank you.
We were reluctant to leave Ile de Grâce after the fantastic welcome that we got there. But we were a proud bunch as we followed Daddy Duck into Lorient. It's raining in Baltimore. The entrance to Lorient is impressive, with the Citadel on your right and further up on the left, the old naval base. I need a phone call. Corey Larkin was an excellent host. He had arranged for Bruno here to play us an Irish tune as we disembarked. I'm not sure you'll all recognize the tune he's playing. No? It was Sunday Bloody Sunday by U2.
Yay! More!
Thank you very much.
Smiling faces all round. It was all of 200 metres up to the pub. La Villa Margaret was Pádraic's third pub in Lorient, after the Galway Inn and the Westport. We were treated to a couple of hours of open bar, some free food, and great music.
Oh, people passing by, I see friends, even me, and I'm saying,
of course, it wasn't long before we were making our own music. Dave O'Connor, another man that could memorize 100 verses.
The instinct of the crater, the best thing in nature for sinking your sorrows and raising your joys. Oh, Lord, tis delighting for courting or fighting. There's not so exciting as whiskey boys. Liquid cosmetic for lovers athletic or ladies pathetic can bring such a bloom. For as sweet by the powers of old gardening flowers wouldn't give her out about such a darling perfume. If in this liquor so rare, if you're wishing to share, to be turning your hair, whether it's drizzled or rained. Sure, it's said that the merit when they, the true spirit so strong, will be turning the hair in your head. The instinct of the crag, they're the best thing in nature for sinking your sorrows and raising your joys. Oh, since it's perfection, no dark direction can guard the complexion like whiskey boys. When a child in my cradle, nurse with a ladle was filling my mouth with a notion of pep. When a drop from her bottle slipped into my frock, and when I capered and I wriggled clean out of her lap. On the floor I lay crawling, both kicking and bawling, till mother and father were both to the fore, all sobbing and crying. Conceived I was dying, but soon found I only was screeching for more. The instinct of the crater, the best thing in nature, forsaking your sorrows and raising your joys. Oh Lord, how they chuckle if babes in their truckle they only could suckle with Christ's eyes. Through my youth was the impression of years of depression, my childhood's impressions still come to my mind. Or at school or at college, the bonus of knowledge I never could go to with whiskey combined. And as older I'm growing, time's ever bestowing on Aaron's quotation a flavor so fine. And ere they might lecture about Job and his nectar, itself is the only true liquor divine. The instinct of the crater, the best thing in nature, for sinking your sorrows and raising your joys. All art is delighting for courting or fighting, there's not so exciting as whiskey boys.
A woman from Tipperary came up to me in the beer garden asking if I knew where the sailors were that had come from Ireland. She was looking for a bunch of blazers, but was a little bit taken aback by the ramshackle group that were laid out in front of her. It was the West of Ireland crusty sailors on tour.
Broken hearted, but she copes. Michael's out of work. Feels he's sinking in the muck. He's unshaven and a mess. Finds it hard some days to dress. Stevie smashed to death, 'cause he can't express himself.
Lads and ladies giving it gusto, with our boats tied to the marina outside the window behind. Golden. some lads didn't know when to go home. We were all up early for the tour of La Base. This was a heavily constructed concrete U-boat base. The base had been featured in one of the most tense movies of all time, Des Boat. It had been transformed by Lorient City Council from a derelict shipyard to a modern racing yacht building facility. The catamaran shown here is built by Marsudan in their factory at the base. This is the TS-42 that you can pick up for a mere 750,000 euro. We observed them building the TS-50 on our visit. You can get some idea of the scale of the vessel when you see the man working in the field. This vessel was at the fit-out stage. And here's one sitting on the marina outside. Next up was our formal visit to Hotel de Ville Lorient. We were given a very warm welcome by Assistant Mayor Marie-Christine Barreau. Our French consul from Galway, Catherine Gagnon, had flown out specially for the occasion. And here's Johnny, doing us all proud. French authorities had reported afterwards that they were delighted with the turnout of 80 sailors. Again, the French newspaper coverage was generous. And then the weary sailors retired to the Galway Inn for a final hurrah. This lad is looking fairly happy with himself after masterminding the efforts of getting two Galway boats to Lorient. Another mastermind, Jean Gab, gave us a lovely rendition of an old Breton song. Set off from Lorient after an excellent visit. Week-long trip home beckoned. Huge thanks was due to all the skippers and crew that took part. It wouldn't have been any sort of event without their commitment. A lingering memory are the excellent relationships that were built up over the event. One question lingered. Who was the real Eugene? While it'll be a very long time before we go on a big adventure again, we might do something modest next year.
The city meets the sky. Most days stay the same. Please stay, cause fear will not die. If I had a boat, I would sail to you, hold you in my arms, ask you to be true.
Thanks to all those who helped in any way to make this trip happen. Thanks also for coming out tonight to watch it with us, and hope to see you on the water soon.